I'm Victoria Pirro for Profiles. This week we visited the home of Dr. Robin Lacy. He is Professor Emeritus of the School of Theater at Ohio University. And in his backyard is an extraordinary scale model replica of the old Marietta and Cincinnati Railroad. The M&C ran through Athens and was in operation from before the Civil War until 1926.
But it's all adjusted halfway between the requirements of the garden and the requirements of the historical meaning of the railroad.
Because his father was employed by the Denver and Rio Grande Railroad, Dr. Lacy has been intrigued by trains and railroading since he was a child.
Oh, I had O-scale trains, I had HO-scale trains, I built a big N-scale railroad here in Athens. I have done trains all my life, but never this size. This large size, large-scale train is my first attempt at this, and I like it a lot.
The scale of the garden railways is 1 to 22.5. The tracks are about 3 inches apart.
About 150 feet of track by the time you count the loops on both ends. At scale, it's about a mile of track.
Through careful research, Dr. Lacy has rekindled some of the spirit of the railroad during the life of the M&C.
I have done a great deal of research on the Marietta Union Station, but the station was torn down in 1948. So it has required going back to look for that information. Over at Cincinnati, the Niles factory, the white station, the white building over there, you may have noticed has a locomotive inside of it being fabricated for the railroad. They built 7 of the first locomotives for the M&C. The building seemed to be an appropriate way to symbolize Cincinnati, both from the point of view of the factory and the little Gothic tower on the top, which is a strict reconstruction of what Niles did to the top of their factory. Gothic architecture in conjunction with railroads is very widespread. The whole Gothic revival came as much from the railroads as from anything else.
One of the high points of the Garden Railway from an historical perspective is the Dead Man's Trestle. He showed me the 3 main parts of the trestle and how each represents different times in history. These pictures demonstrate his devotion to accuracy in his recreations. And if you think that such attention to detail is time-consuming, you're right.
Any time I'm not doing something else, I am at this. There are 4 or 5 projects in various stages of completion downstairs in my little shop. There are painting projects, there are construction projects.
So much for the notion of a rocking chair retirement. What about the future of the garden railways? And is it still growing, or are you pretty satisfied with where
it is? I have a typed page of 35 projects ahead of me, Victoria. A model railroad is never complete. It's never done. If it's done, I'm done.